Welcome to Hawk's Eye View, Waltham High Source News. I'm Daniel Burke.
And I'm Ryan Landry. This week, it's all about you, the students.
Our fellow TV students will be testing you and discovering different things about you.
First up, we have Ryan and CJ, seeing if you can guess the price of that shirt.
The shirts go from lower prices to higher prices.
Let's go check it out.
Thanks, Dan and Ryan. Today, we're doing a segment called The Price is Right. We have shirts varying in price range. So let's get into it. What's the
price? First shirt is a Thrasher shirt. It's $25. It's not as expensive as some of the other shirts we have, but it's still a pretty cool shirt. The quality is probably not as good as some of the other shirts we have, but it's still pretty cool. So
there we go. Looking at the shirt, I'm going to guess 40 to 60.
I went low, so I'm gonna say 32 for the second one.
This is an Adidas shirt. It's about $40. The quality is pretty good on them. I think that's why it makes it $40, but not as expensive as some of the other shirts and probably not as good quality as some of the other ones.
Okay. So, going to a guess since it's Adidas, 60 to 100?
$40. Alright. Let's say $22.
Right, so this is a Coma de Garcon shirt. It is made by a Japanese designer. And the quality is really good on these, and I think that's why it makes it $100.
Okay. Oh, I know this brand. I forgot how much money it costs, though. I'm gonna say like $200.
$45. $18 for this one.
So this is an off-white shirt. It's made by a designer, Virgil Abloh. He's good friends with Kanye West. He's actually his creative director. So yeah, it's a really nice shirt. It's stitched, embroidered. The label's nice, just the overall quality of the shirt's nice, and I think that's why it makes it $320.
I totally forgot how much these cost. I know this is expensive for no reason. $400?
Let me try it on. $125.
Thanks, alright. They keep going up in price, but I think this might be, I'm gonna say 30.
Make sure to tune in next week on Hawk's Eye View. Back to Dan and Ryan in the studio.
Fun fact, for the price of two of those last shirts, it can get you an iPhone 8.
In total, that's $407. That could pay for 4 months of my car insurance.
Anyways, we have Jake and Jaden seeing if you guys can guess that food. Go ahead, guys.
Thanks, guys.
So today, Jaden and I have met up with four students to see who could guess the food first in the competition.
Let's get right into it. Okay, so you guys can guess now.
Pickle.
What's a pickle?
It's a pickle.
Yeah, definitely a pickle.
Don't guess until you're done.
I got it.
Me too.
Okay, what is it?
Honey Nut Cheerios.
Yep, Honey Nut Cheerios.
What, is there an echo in here?
Cheerios.
Cheerios.
Oh. What the?
Okay, what do you guys think it is?
I have no idea.
A date.
No, it's a fruit. It's a fruit that covered in yogurt.
Uh-uh. Oh.
That's not
would
what it
you
tastes
ever
like.
Have guessed that?
No.
No, I wouldn't have. No.
Oh my god.
It's mm-mm. not bad. What is that, Mott's?
I don't like that.
It's Welch's.
No. Oh, that's good.
What is...
I have no idea what this is. Or is it like... I think chewy, but it's not a raisin, is it?
Oh, is it the yogurt thingies? Yogurt bite?
Oh, they like, it's like yogurt covered something.
What do you think it is?
I don't know.
I have no idea.
Is it yogurt covered?
Yeah. What is this?
What do you guys think this is?
It's either banana,
it's like
strawberry,
baby food.
Kiwi, baby food.
It's banana.
Oh, let's go.
Oh.
This is good. You like perfectly got.
Banana something.
Yeah, it tastes bananas. It's like banana yogurt.
No. Banana. Is it just mushed up banana?
No. Pureed bananas.
Baby food.
Yeah.
Is it really? Ew.
Thanks, guys. That was pretty fun.
Great job to everyone who participated. Now let's get back to Dan and Ryan in the studio.
Thanks, Jake and Jaden.
Wow, those kids did really well.
In other news, we have Kara and Jalen interviewing some teachers and students about the ASL programs. Take it away, guys.
Today we had a chance to catch up with Ms. Bellman, the ASL teacher, and some of her students. Keep watching to find out more information about her ASL class.
Hi, I'm Eileen Bellman. My name sign is this. I am the American Sign Language teacher and English 9 teacher here at Waltham High School. I've recently been teaching at McDevitt Middle School, and while I was there, I had the resource room class, and I was doing the American Sign Language Club there.
How and when did you learn sign language?
It's a very interesting story. My mom would always have a summer project for my sister and I to do. We went to a bookstore that was near our house, and I found a book about American Sign Language, and I memorized it that whole summer. So I was about 10. My mother called my principal and told him that I was interested in sign language. It was a deaf girl going to our school, and he paired us up together. Her family was all deaf. I used to hang out with them, and I learned sign language that way. And then through my entire life, I was in the deaf community, and then I studied interpreting at Northeastern University. We often think of foreign languages as the spoken languages, and now Waltham is opening up their hearts and their minds to a signed language, a visual language. In addition to which, American Sign Language is the fourth most spoken language in the world.
What made you interested in American Sign Language?
Growing up, my best friend, she had parents that were deaf, so whenever I would go over, they would speak and I wouldn't really understand, so I really wanted to get into the culture.
My mom has worked with the disabled before, and I think it's really cool being able to like communicate in other ways.
Okay, can you guys sign something for us?
So I'm gonna show you American Sign Language how to say have a good Friday, have a great weekend. Have sign for good and the sign for Friday.
Thanks for watching. We hope you learned something new.
Please contact Ms. Bellman if you're interested in learning anything about ASL.
Thanks, Karen and Jalen.
That class was really interesting. I might have taken it next year.
Yeah, and it counts as a foreign language.
Now let's go to Will and Raph that went to the weight room to see how you can stay in shape.
Take it away.
Thanks, guys. Today, we decided to go down and check out the fall strength and conditioning program.
Let's go check out some of the toughest and strongest guys at Waltham High School.
Let's go. My favorite exercise is the bench press.
My favorite exercise is probably squatting, because you know, I play basketball and you definitely need your legs as much as possible. Running up and down the court all the time, just trying to jump as high as possible, I'm gonna say squatting.
My favorite exercise would have to be either one-legged squats or two-legged.
Yeah, I listen to music all the time. Like, I can't not listen to music. My favorite is rap.
It depends, because like if I'm with my friends, I kind of like to talk, chill, you know. But if I'm by myself, I definitely like to listen to music. And I definitely like to listen to some hip-hop, you know, some rap, just to get me pumped up and get ready for my workout.
I do listen to music, but it's usually whatever the boys put on.
My main reason for wanting to work out is football, stay in shape for it.
The reason for me to working out is just because I play basketball, and I was kind of skinny before, so I wanted to be able to get to the rack, finish nice and strong, and just get better.
I work out so I could build up muscle and just be stronger and have better endurance and stamina.
No, it doesn't really happen. You know, we just kind of joke around. You know, if people are small, kind of make fun of them, whatever. You're lifting small, you're not big, so, you know, got to get big.
Not that I know of.
Yeah. I haven't seen any personally, but I do. I've heard, like, stories.
Working out, it gives you confidence in yourself and makes you feel more comfortable.
That's a tough question because like it's really hard to encourage people. Like they should really have it in their heart, but you know, like if I have to, I just tell them, you know, you gotta get better. You know, you gotta get better some way. So why not hit the weights?
I usually just tell people that if they wanna like just be the better them to help just be stronger.
My brother motivates me to work out the most because he's always getting bigger than me and I always want to catch up.
When I see players like in the NBA, college, the higher tier high school athletes, I just get really motivated because I want to be at that level at one point, you know, and they're doing something right, so I really want to try what they're doing.
Usually my friends and family.
I'm going on 13 years, so 13 years. There have been a great amount of people. I've had up to about 50 kids at one time. Absolutely. As a matter of fact, when field hockey ends, Coach Nugent has her basketball players come in and do workouts every day.
Looks like a really good program. I think I'm going to start going every day now.
Back to you guys at the studio.
And that's this week's edition of Hawkside View.
Keep tuning in for more information.
See you next time on
Hawkside View.
That looked really bad.
Boom. That was good.
All right, cool. Good. Done.